Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to walk you through step-by-step how to deploy a Cloudflare worker that's connected to your RavenDB database. Before we start, I'm going to assume you're already familiar with what Cloudflare workers are used for and are using RavenDB in some capacity. If that doesn't sound like you, check out a more general introduction to Cloudflare workers that showcases using RavenDB at the link below. You'll also need a Cloudflare account, your RavenDB client certificate to connect, a GitHub account, and Node.js installed. I use Visual Studio Code in the demo, but you can use whatever editor you prefer as long as you have Git installed locally and can push to GitHub. In case you get stuck, there is a written companion guide you can follow with a link in the description below that provides more details. Let's get started. To find the RavenDB Cloudflare worker template, if you didn't already find it, head to github.com/RavenDB and then filter by Cloudflare. To kick off the process, click this Deploy with Workers button. This opens up a deployment wizard created by Cloudflare that sets everything up through GitHub. If you want more control or you're not using GitHub, there is a manual process which is provided in the written companion to this video. This deployment wizard is probably the easiest way to get started though. First, authorize the Cloudflare deployer to access your GitHub account. Next, we need some information from our Cloudflare account. If you already have an account, you can click the blue button, otherwise you'll have to create a new account. First is the account ID, so click the Workers dashboard link. Copy the ID on the right side of the page, go back and paste it into the box. The other info we'll need is an API token with permission to edit workers. This is used to actually deploy our worker later on in GitHub Actions. If you don't have a token already, you'll need to create it. Open your profile, then click API tokens and create a new token. Click the Edit Worker Use Template button to create a token with the defaults that we need. You can rename it to something more descriptive like My Worker GitHub Actions. We'll have to pick the account to include and the zones to access. You probably want to be a little bit more specific than this in production so that you grant least privilege. Continue to summary, then copy the secret. Cloudflare will not display it again. Now we'll go back to the other screen and paste it into the API token field. Next, click Connect Account. It'll prompt you to fork the repository into your personal GitHub account, not an organization, but you can move the repo after it gets made. Once that's done, click the link to enable workflows on the repository. Come back and click Workflows Enabled. Everything is set up, so it'll ask if you want to go ahead and start the deployment, which we do. This'll take a bit of time. This badge updates in real time, but let's go back to the GitHub repo and view the action being executed. If something fails, you can click the job to view the details and the error message. It may be that your API token doesn't have the right permissions or you provided the wrong account ID. You can go into your repository settings and update the secrets if that's the case. Now, let's go back to the deployment screen since it looks like it's done. Click the Workers dashboard link and we'll see that the new worker has showed up. Now click the URL to view the worker and it's working. You can see by default it's connecting to the RavenDB live test cluster. Now that we've validated the template works, let's connect it to our own cluster with certificate authentication. Before we continue to clone the repo locally, we need to update a couple things since Cloudflare forked the template. In the repository settings, rename the repository to whatever you prefer instead of template, then unmark the repository as a template since this is the actual worker. Great, now we can clone the repository and not worry about renaming it later. I'll go into Visual Studio Code, open the terminal, copy the clone command, and run it. Once cloned, the template is built with Node.js. Check your version with Node-V, and then cd into the project directory, and you can also do cat.nvmrc to check the version needed by the repository. As long as your version matches or is higher, the following steps should all work. Run npm install and wait for it to complete. Once it's ready, I'll open the repo in Visual Studio Code, and now we can configure the worker using Wrangler, a tool that's part of Cloudflare's Workers SDK. It's already installed in the repo, but you could install it globally with npm as well. Open wrangler.toml and update this worker-name config setting because you probably don't want to use the template name. This could just be the name of your repo. Once you do this, on the next deployment, you will actually get a new worker created and the old worker will still be lying around. We'll clean that up at the end. Next, we need to modify the connection to RavenDB, and I'll use RavenDB Cloud as the example, but you'll need to get the same information if you're running the on-prem version. In my RavenDB Cloud dashboard, I've got my cluster here. The URLs we need are shown and can be copied, which I'll paste back into the db underscore URLs config setting. If you have multiple nodes in the cluster, the URLs need to be comma separated. The other value to update is db underscore name, which is the default database to connect to in your cluster. Again, you want to make sure that the database exists, otherwise you'll get an error when you try to run this later. You want to do the same thing under the env.production section, if they are different from your development variables. Now we need to configure the certificate binding that's commented out. Go back into the cloud dashboard, click the download certificate button, which opens up a modal, and you can click the download client certificate package button to download a package containing the client certificates we can use to connect. This is a cluster certificate and has wide permissions to allow you to manage the cluster. For production purposes, it would be better to generate a specific client certificate with more limited access. But for this demo, it doesn't matter which certificate you use as long as it has access to the database. Once the package is downloaded, extract it to an easy-to-access location, but take care not to accidentally store the certificates inside the repo because not all the files are password protected. There are two files we'll use next, the CRT file and the key file. Copy the path to the cert file. On Windows, holding Shift and right-clicking gives you the option to copy as path. Now we can use Wrangler to upload the client certificate to our Cloudflare account. To do that, I'll go back to VS Code, then open the terminal and I'll type in the npx wrangler mtls certificate upload command. There's going to be a few arguments. The first is dash dash cert, which will be the path to the cert file we just extracted. The second is going to be dash dash key, which is the key file that sits right next to the cert file. And the final argument is dash dash name, which will be the name of the certificate in the Cloudflare dashboard, so make it descriptive. Run the command. And if this is the first time you're running Wrangler, you'll probably need to sign into your Cloudflare account, so it'll open a browser window and follow that flow. Once you're done, you can come back to the terminal. If the command gives you an unable to parse certificate error, make sure the certificate files are valid. Wrangler expects the public key file for the cert argument and the private key file for the key argument. Once uploaded, we can copy the certificate ID right here for the next step. I'll open the Wrangler TOML file again. We need to uncomment these lines that bind the certificate to the worker, and we need to replace the certificate ID placeholder with the certificate ID I just copied. That's all we need to configure the worker to connect to our RavenDB instance. We can test it locally before we deploy these changes. I'll run npm run dev, which starts Wrangler in development mode. Once Wrangler starts up your worker, you should see a message like this where it has access to our mTLS certificate. So let's open the browser using the B key. And it looks like we're connected to our cluster. Awesome. So let's go back into Visual Studio Code so I can show you the console. There's a message here that says a bound cert was found and will be used for RavenDB requests. So if you see this message, then everything is working. If you don't see this message or something else has blown up, check out the troubleshooting documentation for help, which is linked in the description. I'm going to commit these changes now and push them up to the repo, which will kick off a deployment. You can also do a manual deployment by running npm run deploy. Back in the Cloudflare dashboard, after a few minutes, you'll see the new worker has been deployed. To check if certificate authentication works in production, open the worker URL and check to see if we get the same message. And we do! If this isn't working, you can view the variables being set in the worker and make sure the certificate binding is displayed here. If your variables don't seem right, you can adjust them in your Wrangler TOML file. Refer to the troubleshooting for more help. There's one last thing to do, which is to clean up the old worker that was originally deployed with the template name. So click into that old worker, click the Manage Service button, and then Delete down below. Fill out the name of the worker to confirm, and boom, all cleaned up. Keep in mind that as long as your worker is deployed, you are using up your free usage if requests are being handled, so this would be a good time to remove all the workers you don't intend to use. To learn more about using RavenDB with Cloudflare, there are links to resources below, and we look forward to hearing about the cool stuff you're building. Thanks.